Good evening one and all, I am Dr. Kavarish Kumar. I am here with a new video about a rare primary malignant bone tumor called as chordoma. So chordoma is a rare primary malignant bone tumor which arises from the vestigial remnants of the notochord. It is so rare that its incidence is just about 1%. Location wise, the most common involved locations of chordoma is the sacrococcygeal area, which corresponds to 50% of the total number of lesions, whereas 35% of the lesions can still occur in the clivus. 15% of the lesions can involve the true vertebral bodies. Of all the vertebral bodies, C2 vertebral body is the most common site of occurrence of chordoma. Radiological features. Radiologically, the lesion presents with a destruction involving either the sacrum or the base of the skull. The lesion presents as a lytic destructive lesion along with an adjacent soft tissue component. And if you look closely within the lesion, there will be areas of amorphous calcification. Rarely, a spinal lesion can present as a solitary ivory vertebral body. So, in case of sacrococcygeal chordoma, the patient usually presents with a localized pain with associated present symptoms involving the bladder and the rectum. So here is an AP view of the pelvic region where we see there's a large lytic destructive lesion involving the sacrum and the coccygeal region. The lesion is also showing adjacent soft tissue component with areas of amorphous calcifications within the lesion. This is characteristic of chordoma. So here is another image of AP view of the pelvic region where we see that there is a large lytic destructive lesion involving the sacrum and the coccyx with associated adjacent soft tissue component and areas of amorphous calcifications within the lesion, which are all classic signs of chordoma. Spino-occipital chordoma. The patient with spino-occipital chordoma usually presents with a long-lasting headache, and because of the lesion, the patient can also present with symptoms of pressure effects on the adjacent structures, resulting in ocular disturbances, increased intracranial pressure, ataxia, deafness, and tinnitus. So here we have an image of a classical chordoma involving the spinoclavian region, where we see that there is a lateral X-ray of the skull showing a large lytic destructive lesion at the region of the clivus. The lesion is also showing areas of amorphous calcifications within the lesion. This is classic signs of chordoma. Vertebral chordoma. Cervical spine is the most common involved spinal region in case of vertebral chordoma. Of the cervical spine, C2 vertebral body is the most common involved vertebral body. In case of cervical spine vertebral chordoma, the patient presents with dysphagia, sensory complaints in the form of numbness in the arms or the legs, or motor weakness in the form of paraplegia or quadriplegia with associated vertebral body collapse. So here we have an image where we see that there is a large lytic destructive lesion with areas of sclerosis as well as lyxis involving predominantly the C2 vertebral body. The lesion is also showing involvement of the posterior neural arch as well as the spinous process. What we see here is that there are areas of amorphous calcifications within the lesion, and there's also a subtle area of radio opacity just anterior to the lesion, which represents the adjacent soft tissue component. The same patient, when he underwent CT scan, on sagittal view, we see that the soft tissue component is hyperdense and enhancing on post-contrast study with involvement of adjacent spinal cord as well. Pathological features. Pathologically, it's a well-encapsulated mass lesion with involvement of more than one vertebral body. One thing that we have to remember that it is the only primary malignant tumor that is known to cross the intervertebral disc. And microscopically, there's one term that you have to remember and which could be asked in your NEET exams is physliferous cells. These are the characteristic cells seen in chordoma on microscopy. Treatment-wise, Sacrococcygeal lesion can undergo resection. Radiation therapy can be used for clavial as well as vertebral body lesions. The prognosis of intracranial and vertebral lesions is poor, with most patients dying within 3 years of age. However, the 5-year survival for sacrococcygeal chordoma is just 8.7%. I hope this video has helped you guys.